In this video, I want to show you how to use VR and Blender to plan out a workspace. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales. This video is sponsored by Thangs. This video is all about sharing my current Blender VR workflow. It's still heavily under development. What we're going to be using in this video is Blender XR by Marui plugin, as well as using something called OVR Toolkit so that I can have a screen of Blender inside of Blender. Right, so I'm going to do my absolute best to explain what the madness is that's going on here before we jump into this. As you can see in the background over there, that's very much Blender XR, the actual application. Now, I'm going to bring up another screen right here, and this here, this is my actual view in here. And using OVR tools, I can get a screen inside of Blender. So now I am inside of Blender with Blender open up on a screen. Now this is incredible because this gives me the chance to basically interact with the VR environment with me in it. Just to give you an example, I have a roof right this minute. I can just press H and the roof is gone. I can go to this back wall, press H, the back wall's gone. I can go and see that table there on my right. I can select it and press G, Shift, Z, and I can just move it around to wherever it is that I want. Now, you can do this in a myriad of ways. Right this minute, I have it set that I am in the environment itself. You could actually set this up so that what you're modeling is just off out to the distance. So you're modeling on the screen, you're just looking to the right to check out how it looks. It is an incredible modeling experience. And in fact, I love using Blender like this for things that you really shouldn't use it for. So for instance, 3D print design, I love to design something up and it's literally coming to life right in front of me. It is amazing. So with this quick overview of what exactly is going on, I hope that explains the madness, and let's jump into the rest of the video. In case you don't know, Thangs is a community for 3D enthusiasts where you can select and download from over 3.4 million free models. As soon as you upload a model to Thangs, it's automatically converted into augmented reality, which you can check out using their no app needed AR viewer. This is a fantastic way to share and show files when you're out and about. For example, use the link in the description and check out my new workshop layout for yourself. Let me know if I've missed anything out. By using that link, you're not only checking out the fastest growing 3D community with loads of great features, but you're helping me make more videos like this. And for that, thank you.
Right in front of me, that there is the view that I see. Down here is just basically sort of the same as the view that I see, except this is the screen that I have up in my 3D space. So that's sort of my Blender work interface. And then down there in the angle, that is sort of just like an overall rendered view live of this space. Now, there are so many different ways of working within virtual reality and doing this. I find that for my own needs, the best one is this, having a keyboard and mouse right here so that I can just go and interact directly with everything. Yes, it's a little bit weird sometimes, but it's all there. So first, let's get all of this stuff into the workshop. So I can see it. It is just out over there for me. But I'm going to just literally just let's grab what for me this here would be the new resin printer, all of these little bits and bobs. Actually, yeah, now let's just bring this all in because then I would know sort of the space allocation that's needed for what I'm wanting to do here. So let's bring that over to here and I can just turn around and straight away just see and inspect this a little bit. If I want to have my hands in the space, because I'm using Blender XR, they do have some nice little hand in spaces. I could even actually interact with things, but I find that Blender XR isn't exactly, what would I say, the most intuitive way of working with it. Look, if I go for moving and I select this printer, here we go, it's moving about, but I want it to only be, let's say, only on the XY. It's now going to be only XY up there, so I have to undo that. And then I can go back and move this around. So here we go. I can move this wherever I want. I'll leave that there for now. I'm not going to bother because there's no need to. And right, I think that goes pretty well. I like taking a look around in the space, and I have a feeling that I like where that table is. And maybe I have some shelving units outside here that I'll bring in. So let's just bring those in just so we get an idea of what we have as well. So I'll bring those in. So I'm just going to go over here. Let's bring this one in here. So I'll go G and then just take a look. It's surreal to bring things in to virtual reality while you're in it. It's pretty crazy. I have the air compressor that I definitely need to bring in. I think if I bring this in under that table there, that looks all right to me, but it might need a little tweaking later on down the line. You know what? Let's do a big tweak now. I think what I'm wanting to do is move this table. So let's do that. So I'm going to move this over here, I think. I'm going to rotate it. Let's go for a 180-degree rotation. And now it's just moved over there on my left-hand side, which is pretty good. I'll snap that into place. And look, there's actually a nice little gap here. I did not expect that. So I'm going to grab those shelves. They look like they might fit there. So let's bring that in, rotate it some 90 odd degrees. And that is going to fit. You know what? I'm actually going to use Blender XR for this part just because I want to. So I'm going to move you into there. And let's just check that that's not going to... Okay, I've got moved it a little bit too far. You know what? Let's go back to Blender. This is why... Like, it's nice to just be able to move things, but at the same time, it's quite nice to get an accurate positioning as well. So, G, move this. I want to move it right to about there. That's where I want it. All right, so now with that, there, let's start moving those things. I think I'm going to move it with this for now. I'm going to get my new printer. Let's put you over here. The wash and cure station. Let's put you here. The air purifier. You know what? I think over in that corner would go quite well. Yeah, that goes nicely. And this here is going to be my ultrasonic cleaner. I quite like the idea of putting it down in this nook. So let's use a bit of Blender snapping to put that in a better spot. So let's go G, Z, snap it to there. Let's also put this in a little bit of a better position than I just put it in. So a little bit like that. Okay, that's looking nice. Now, obviously, this table isn't in the right place. So let's move that to the right position. Let's go move it over to there. And I quite like where that is. It doesn't take up too much space here in VR. It doesn't look that like overwhelming. So let's actually bring that pretty much to where I am right this minute. So let's rotate that 90 degrees. Let's take a good look at where this is going. I'm going to plop that right about there. Take a good top view of this and just bring it out a touch. That's looking good to me. There indeed. Now, my CR10 printer, this is a little bit big and it's taking up an entire workbench. So I'm actually going to bring in some new geo. I'm going to basically copy the tabletop that I have here and bring it down. So let's go into edit mode, select this up, duplicate it, part it out with the selection, grab that and whack it down here. Is that right? That is perfectly on point. Yep, that is where I want it. And you guessed it, I'm going to put this down here. Will that fit? It will. It'll fit quite nicely, actually. Awesome. Okay, that's cool. Let's just move this a little bit on the X, just so it's closer that way. I'm happy with that. And now shelving-wise, I've got two shelves that I can put in here. One are these big metal stacking shelves, and this other one is a big wooden beast here. Now, I don't know. Do I want that wooden one there? Just feels like I'm missing out a lot of height shelf-wise here. So what I'm going to do is let's bring in the metal ones. Let's also space them out and see how many I can get in. Maybe I can get them all in. I don't know. So let's see. So I'll just bring that around over to here. And these are pretty big. These are 45 centimeters by 1 meter. So they're pretty decent size. Let's take a look from up above as well, so that we make sure that we're not getting ourselves in too much of a pickle. There's a little bit of a gap here on the side, which I guess I could put some type of long material in there. So let's grab all of these. Let's go GZ300 and reselect those. I could have just deselected one. Oh well. GZ300, GZ, you know what, I think we're going to fit them all in, and that's pretty cool, because that means we get a whole bunch more shelving in here, which is just what I'm wanting. Yes, let's see. Oh, that's nice. That's nice, that's nice. I'm happy with that. That is looking really nice indeed. So, but why is that all moved out of place? Let me just move that printer back to where it should be. And let's also get, so these things here are representational of some silicon mats that I've bought. And I want to look at the colors now a little bit. So I've got two black ones. One of them is a really thin black one that I want to have on this workbench, I think. Another gray one here. Maybe I want... How do I want to do this? How do I want to do this? Maybe what I'll do is I'll set this. Do I want to set this as like the printer's silicon one? And then I have one for like supplies on that side. Another one for the resiny bit here. And then I just have one over here for whatever other projects I'm doing. Does that work? I don't know. Let's see. How's that looking? Yeah, that is looking good. It does seem pretty natural. Let's take a look from here. Let's just move this to a position a little closer to the edge. Somewhere there. Move UG. said, you know what? We should probably do some snapping here. So let's go on the Y snap to that point here, please. And then you snap as well to that point there, and then you guys snap together, and you snap to that point there. That's looking nice, actually. That's looking really nice. I think I want to move the printer, though, just a little bit more in this direction. Let's see. Oops, I've got the wrong thing selected. Undo that. I want to select the printer, please. Yep. Yeah. Then there I can keep my supplies. This can be the mat that I clean constantly. There is my ultrasonic cleaner. Let's just put that in a little bit more of a central position that we have set here, just so that it looks nicer in general. Yeah, it also means that if this ever spills, it's not going to be on anything nasty. We're going to need that space. You know what? I'm pretty happy with how this is going. So let's bring back the walls. Oh, so you might not be able to see that on my screen, of course, but here now the space is shut. I am happy with this plan. Oh, the compressor. I want to move that. See, this is something that's really good about checking the space and planning the space like this. You can really be in the space and decide if you want that or not. So I can actually move that closer over here. I can still push it back a bit. So let's do that. On the Y. And pull that back to there. And then that's nice and cozy up there because I can then use that with the resin. Just go straight from here, dunk it into there. I'm going to have to find a mat or cover that area up there. But yeah, I think we have this planned out. As you can see, there is the screen that I've been using. And let's see how this turns out in reality, I guess. That's how I went ahead and planned my new clean space.
And there you have it. That's my in-development VR Blender workflow. I love it. I find it incredibly enjoyable to actually do Blender VR inside of Blender. It really is a surreal experience. And if you ever get the chance to do it, I strongly would suggest you do it. Now, currently, I can't seem to get it to work on my Quest 2, but I have been able to get it to work on my HTC Vive. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome. And it means the world to have your support. It really does make these videos possible. And if you're enjoying what I'm doing here, and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord where I share more of this craziness down in the description below. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.